The Shafi'ullah, he say that it is a kafara, it is an expiation that is due in regard to that. That is a expiation that is attached to that. Based on the hadith that is being mentioned in regard to that. That is based on the hadith that is mentioned in regard to that. Na'am. On the authority of Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu arda, if you'll pay enough, alhamdulillah, attention enough, that we mention about two ahadith from Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu wa arda, three, this is the third one, right? The first one from Abu Hurairah was what? Man nasiya, wa huwa sa'im, whoever forget, while he's fasting, eating and drinking, let him complete his fasting, for indeed Allah is the one that quenches fast and yani fed him. And the second hadith of Abu Hurairah was, whoever vomited naturally, then he is no qada. But whoever made himself to vomit, it is upon him to make the qada, to make it up again. So the third hadith of Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu arda is as follows. Na'am. So he said, Abu Hurairah, he said, we were sitting along with the messenger, in the mix of the messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That resembled what hadith? What hadith does it remind Abu Bakr? Abu Bakr, what hadith does that remind you of? Ahsan tabarakallahu feek. Very good. The hadith of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. Very good. Baynama nahnu julusun inda rasul, inda nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We were sitting in the mix with the of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Na'am. If ja'ahu rajulun, and a person suddenly came and said to the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O you messenger of Allah, I am destroyed. I doomed myself. The messenger said, what happened to you? What happened to Ismail Kamil? He said that I went to my wife, waqa'tu ala imra'ati, meaning I had intercourse with my wife. And while I was fasting, I had intercourse with my wife while I was fasting. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, tu'tiquha. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, do you have a slave that you can free? The person say no. Hal. Qala, fahal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, do you have the ability? Shuf, do you have the ability to fast 2 months back to back? So the first question was what? Do you have a slave so you can free her? Why? Because the person did what? What did the person do? Right, he went to his wife while he was fasting. He went to his wife while he was fasting. Right, he went to his wife while he was fasting. Meaning, he had an intercourse with his wife while he was fasting. So he came to the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, ya Rasulullah, I'm destroyed. I'm done. I'm doomed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, ma laka, what is the issue? What is the problem? He said that I have indeed entered in my wife. Meaning I had intercourse with my wife and I was fasting. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, do you have a slave so you can free? Do you have a slave that you can free? The person, he said, no. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "Hal tastati'u an tasuma shahrayn mutatabi'ayn?" Do you have the ability to fast 2 months back to back? He said, "No." He was honest. He was not trying to be brave. He said, "I can't." And it is from the rahmah of Allah that the person knows his ability and stays in his lane. Keep his know himself. He could have said, ya Rasulullah, yes, and then he will not tell, you know, he might not tell the truth. But he was honest, alhamdulillah. He said, no, straight up, no, I can't fast 2 months back to back. Right? And if it was any of us, we would say, yes, I can. Right? But he said straight up no. Nah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him the third option. Can you feed 60 poor people? Can you feed 60 poor people? So the order right here is very important. The order right here, right? The order here is very important. The first question the Prophet asked him was, do you have a slave you can free? He said, no. He said, can you fast 2 months back to back? He said, no. He said, can you feed 60 people? He said, no. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiled, alayhi salatu wasalam.
Utiya.
So he said that we were there, and a person came and gave the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam a bucket of dates, like a container of date. A person came, we were just sitting, and a person, and he came and gave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a bucket of date or a container of date. Well, it is a container or a bucket and the likes of this. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked, where was the person that was asking? Where was the person that was asking? For you? And he said, here I am, Ya Rasulallah. Fatasaddaq bihi. He said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, take this and give it into charity. Take this bucket of date or this container of date and give it out in charity. The person, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, can you find anyone, this is the wording, would you find anyone that is more, that is poorer? That's the word? That's the word to say? More poor? What do you say? Poorer or more poor? Huh? That's how you say it? Barakallah. Huh? It's not a word? More poor. Poorer, okay. I'm just, huh? Poor. What's the word? More poor? Very good. Let's take that. Barakallah. He's right. Khalas. Also trying to see those who have their GED. But I'm going to take his wording, barakallah fi. He said, Ya Rasulallah, ala afqara minni, giving it to someone that is less fortunate than me, meaning giving it to someone that is more poor than me. He said, by Allah, he said, by Allah, that this is nothing that you will find, meaning someone that will be more poor than me. Meaning between the two valley, right here, between the two valley. He said that you will not find between the two valley a household that is less fortunate than my family. You will not find in between the two valleys a family that is less fortunate than mine. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiled. Hatta badat. Until that his mawlath was shown. His incisive ma'adhira. He was smiling until his incisive was shown. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the end of it, he say, go ahead and feed your family. And go ahead and feed your family. Naam. No, before that, there is وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم You don't have it? Let me see. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه on the authority of أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said a person came to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and he told the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم that I have any broken nafas in Ramadan. He say by way of this hadith. طيب by way of this hadith. طيب by way of this hadith. And on the very end of it, when he mentioned to him, أطعمهُ أهلك and feed your family. At that, in another riwayah of Abu Hurairah again, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم say, he say, كلهُ eat it. أنت وأهل بيتك eat it, you and your family. وصوم يوما واستغفر الله. That eat this, you and your family. Go ahead and feed your family with this. And fast one day, meaning the day that he has yani done that intercourse. And then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. طيب. And ask Allah for forgiveness. So بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, Wednesday, we'll be reading بإذن الله آداب الصيام. What are the etiquettes that one has to endure himself in the month of Ramadan? How does a person's fasting is to be? What are the etiquettes of a fasting person? What are the آداب of fasting in the month of Ramadan? وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. If there was any mistake, please جزاكم الله خيرا. Rectify me. May Allah rectify. وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. حسن الله إليك.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قامت الصلاة.